Yo, Chuck, what's the move, man? I was on my way up here to the studio, you know what I'm saying? And this brother stopped me and asked me, yo, what's up with that brother Chucky D? He sway nice. I said, yo, the brother don't sway nice. He knows he's nice, you know what I'm saying? So, Chuck, I got a feeling you turning into a public enemy, man. Now, remember that line you was kicking at me on the way out to L.A. Lounge to Queens while we was in the car on the way to the shop? Well, yo, right now, kick the bass for them brothers and let them know what goes on.
What goes on?
You know, I oftentimes talk about the effect of a good coach and how that can stay with a person for a lifetime, and how the effects of a coach that's, I won't say bad, but let's just say less than good,
right,
how that can affect the mentality of a young man. We have to be aware that people are going through different things away from school. You never know somebody's situation. But as I try to strive for today, I always tell my coaches, please try to give encouragement.
Right.
Try to give encouragement at all times, you know, because that's something that certainly altered your perspective football career in right. high school, and it could have extended the number of years that you played, you know, it hadn't been some encouraging words from that coach.
I agree. And, you know, even to this day, I use that as how I relate to kids. You know, before I try to get to know all my kids, no matter what sport it is, you know, and, you know, as much as they let in, find out the history, you know, find out what's going on, see where the kid can actually take, you know what I'm saying? Because,
right.
you know, my whole thing, you know, during that time, when you had somebody come up to you and sort of get on you and you don't know them, you know, even though my father knew them, but I still felt some kind of way about, you know, how I feel like if I'm playing for this guy and something happens, and my father's not there, you know, how's he gonna react? So, you know, I really wasn't feeling him. And that's why I really have, when I was coaching, I really tried to get to know my guys. You know, because like you said, we don't know a lot of things that's going on at home. You know, so I try to find out what's going on at home and try to help them before, you know, you tear them down. You gotta build them up before you can tear them down.
Exactly. Now, with that kind of detour away from football as a freshman, is that kind of what led you into playing golf?
Yeah. So, you know, my best friend, he played with his grandfather, and we definitely wanted to do something, and he had played a lot, so I was learning. I'm still learning. So, you know, and back then, actually, our golf team was pretty good because Larissa, who played professional.
Yes.
You know, she was playing golf, so we were able to see a professional every day, you know, and sort of learn from her, learn what not to do, what to do, you know, and it was definitely a great experience. And if people look today, a lot of people play golf, you know, so I've been able to play a little bit, and, you know, you meet a lot of friends and guys that you ordinarily wouldn't meet on a golf course, you know, so it's a way of still being in the game, but not in the game.
Larie was an awesome player in high school. I believe at that time she was the only female
Correct.
On that team.
Yes.
And but yet one of the top golfers on that team. She was an outstanding player. We honored her as a legend of Matoaka High School. Of course, she went on to play for UCLA,
yes.
where she won a national championship. She then played on the PGA Tour, and she even, LPGA. LPGA Tour, and then she's doing an excellent job still working as an associate athletic director, I believe,
Richmond.
At the University of Richmond. Outstanding. Came from Matoaka High School. Now, can you touch on your experience growing up in Ettrick and Matoaka and coming through? Can you talk about the experiences of growing up in kind of a mixed community? As I tell people all the time, Ettrick and Matoaka, we had some of those on the wealthier end. We had some of those on the less wealthy end. We had black, we had white, we had everybody in between. Can you talk a little bit about that experience and your friendships that you developed?
Well, yeah, it's sort of crazy. Even while in high school, we had a few racial incidents. But everybody got along. You know, during that time, I mean, I have some friends today. When you see them in the stores or in the community, it's like taking you back, because it's people that in today's time you might not have been able to associate with. As far as, you know, your relationships and just being friends with people. So it was a little struggle during that time, and like I said, we had a few incidents, but it wasn't to the point where it was going to be total turmoil of the school.
I agree, there was a lot of familiarity as we were starting off in the elementary schools at that time. You just had two feeder schools for elementary in Ettrick and Metoka. You only had, at that time, during the 1980s, one middle school, and then you had one high school for the Metoka district. And everybody kind of knew each other, and we got a chance to experience each other and play with each other and learn with each other. And I always felt that sports was a great unifying factor between all the different groups that made up the Metoka district and brought us together. And I think it even brought the parents together, and those who may not have interacted in other social ways, sports was a very strong unifying factor. Now, beyond high school, can you talk about your university experience? What college you attended, and what was that experience like, and what did you major in?
Actually, I went to Virginia State University, which is right across the street from my house, basically. My freshman year, I stayed on campus to get that college experience, you know, which I would tell anybody, definitely stay on campus. And Virginia State, even though it's across the street, it felt like miles away from home, you know, because you meet different people, you know, you develop friendships. During that time, a lot of people on campus thought I was from D.C., because everybody I was associated with was from D.C. Okay. My roommate was from D.C. The guys that I hung out with was from D.C. You know, and it got to the point I was with them so much, I couldn't stand go-go at first. Then I was a go-go head because my roommate, like I said, was from D.C. and he had one of his uncles that played with Ray Essence. So all of Ray Essence, you know, music was in my room at all times. You know, so it was definitely a good experience. I majored in health, physical education, and recreation. Graduated as a recreation major. Went back and got my certification to be able to teach.
Great story. And during this time, what was your relationship with the Petersburg High School basketball program during these college years?
Well, my first 2 years, it was more getting acclimated to college. Then probably my third year, I was helping with the teams. And then I also started coaching AAU basketball, where at that time I was an assistant coach with Richmond Metro. And the head coach was Vance Harmon, who was actually the head coach of Henrico. So we have a great relationship. We actually went to the national tournament out in Oklahoma City. We carried 12 guys, and I think out of those 12 guys, one of them played professional football, and then we had, I think, maybe two that played professional overseas on the team. And then I had three guys from Petersburg playing with us, Marco Harrison, Don Brooks, and Bernard Johnson. So I had those three. We had some kids from Matterbrook, kids from Ashland area. They went to Patrick Henry. You know, so we had pretty much kids from all over, and that was a great experience to be able to take those guys out there and compete on that national level. And from that point on, I started coaching with Richmond Metro. Guy Buster, I was assistant coach with him, and then did that for maybe a year or two. Then I decided to break off and be under Richmond Metro, but do we call it the Triad team, and that's the Tri-City Edition. So I had guys from all over this Tri-City area, from Metoka, Petersburg, Hopewell, Prince George, Sussex, and we played for a few years. 1 year, I had actually three different levels of kids, to the point where I had the oldest, then Coach Massenberg had the middle age group, and Coach White had the youngest group. And then from there, we did that a few years. Then Coach White sort of branched off, because as I got the head coach, I sort of wanted to stay out of the AAU, and put more input into the actual high school. Even though my AAU was mainly for Petersburg guys, but the rule was you couldn't have more than five from your school on the team.
Right.
So I would have my five, then I would have guys, you know, from other areas. And from that point on, Coach White, he did Petersburg Elite for a couple of years. And then when he went to Richmond, that's when he switched over to his brand now, which is,
Team Loaded.
Team Loaded. Went with Team Loaded, and you know, now he's a national power. You know, all over the country, he's got kids going to these top D1 schools, and you know, he's doing a great job of getting his kids into college and having good teams.
Amazing story, right out of Petersburg.
Right.
Out of Petersburg High School. Now, if I can go back and look at the first coaching gig that you had coming out of Virginia State and coming back to work at Petersburg High School, I believe you started with the ninth grade team?
Yeah, actually my first year with Petersburg, I was the assistant ninth grade coach. Coach Massenberg was actually the head ninth grade coach. And we worked together that year. Then after that, I took over with the ninth grade, and I did ninth grade for probably about 7 to 8 years, coaching ninth grade. And then after that, I got the head job.
The head job. Now, and what year did you first get the head job at Petersburg High School coaching boys basketball?
I was actually named October 4th, 2002.
In that experience, how did that feel to finally ascend to become the head boys basketball coach after such a long journey and seeing, you know, your father in the early days and then going all the way through, you know, all of the AAU experiences, the assistant, coach being on the ninth grade team, and of course I know that you worked as an assistant at the same time in some capacities with the JV and varsity team overseeing all of the players. How did that feel to finally arrive?
It was definitely great. I think my father was happier than I was, because I went through a lot through the interview process. It was a lot of ups and downs within 3-4 months. Like I said, I got it October. And as you know, the season starts in November. So I didn't have really that long period of getting to know the guys, conditioning, even though I knew them, but as a head coach, it's a little different.
Right.
So I went through the process with the interview, and like I said, I was finally named on that date, which was Virginia State's homecoming. So we double celebrated, but like I said, I really believe my father was happier than anybody. Like I said, that was October 4th, and he actually passed away October 24th. So like 20 days after that. And so he was never able to see me as a head varsity coach. You know, he saw me through ninth grade, you know, we talked about a lot of different things. You know, at first, I was a little upset, you know, that he wasn't able to see me. But when I sit back and look at it, it might have been the best thing for me as a coach, because a lot of the critics would have said, oh, he just listened to what his father's saying, dude. You know, so by me, you know, we started out tremendous. I mean, that year we started out on a 7-0 run. You know, like I said in the previews, my first win was against Metoka.
Had to bring that up.
Yeah,
okay.
Yeah. You know, those.
Who was the coach of Metoka?
I think Coach Payton was.
Oh, man. Okay. Yeah. Okay. Okay.
But, you know, to come out, you know, starting 7-0, you know, my first loss was to Prince George, at Prince George, where they had a tremendous team that year. I mean, you had seven great basketball players. Seven great. I mean, Reggie, I think, was a freshman or sophomore on that team. You know, me and Reggie had a great relationship because he played AAU for me. So, you know, we definitely have a great relationship. But, you know, they had Malik. They had Walter as the point guard. They had Donald who could shoot in the corner. I mean, they had just a tremendous team. And so I definitely remember that first loss. You know, as coaches, you know, we really remember mostly our losses than our victories. You know, we always said the victories went to the kids. You know, and I always took blame for every loss. You know, but that was a great experience starting out. And I had probably, that year I had maybe three freshmen playing on the varsity team, where I was starting one, and one was the sixth man, and the other was like my eighth man. You know, so we were very young. I only had four seniors on the team. And like I said, we ended up, my first year, we ended up second in the district.
That's a great start, you know, for the first year, being the head guy. I tell people all the time, you never know what it's like to be in the number one position until you're in the number one position.
Right.
A lot of people can second guess you, and you know, hindsight is 20/20. People want to give you lots of suggestions, mm-hmm. but of course, the leadership has to come from one person and then branch out and flow through his assistant coaches and then through his players, which you hope that are going to be good coaches on the court.
Right.
If I could just read some of the accolades during that first season. The Petersburg High School team finished with 17 wins and 8 losses. That's really good, you know, for your first year. You guys were runners-up in the Fort Lee Christmas Tournament. You were also runners-up in the Central District Tournament that year. You were regional qualifiers. You made the regionals. I believe at that time you had the top four teams in the district tournament.
No, only two.
Only two at that time. I'm sorry, only two teams made it.